We call these kinds of unusual and improbable spontaneous arrangements of matter fluctuations from thermal equilibrium. As strange and improbable as it is, there is an incredibly small but non-zero chance that particles in random motion will spontaneously arrange themselves into something with structure given enough time. Since our universe is moving towards more and more disorganization, or increasing entropy, it stands to reason that one day the universe would have increased its entropy to its maximum limit. Any particles and energy left in the universe would all be randomized and well mixed such that the energy would be evenly distributed everywhere. In this situation, no more work could be done and the universe would essentially be dead without any activity. This is called a heat death to describe one possibility for the end of the universe. Yet, as we know, there are still going to be random thermal fluctuations for the particles within. If time has no limits, then even these random fluctuations could lead to collections of particles that result in something with structure, like the formation of a rock, or maybe a planet, or even a star. Wait long enough, and maybe a whole galaxy will come into existence, or perhaps an entire universe. The larger the resultant organized body, the longer one would have to wait to see it. It's exponentially more likely that a small particle would fluctuate into existence rather than an entire planet. This brings us to the Boltzmann brain scenario. Instead of fluctuating a whole universe into existence that would produce living, intelligent beings within it, it's actually much more likely that a person with a brain and memories would fluctuate into existence directly. Even stranger still, it's even more likely that just a disembodied brain could be fluctuated into existence, such that it remembers being in a universe. If our universe was at its core infinitely vast, with no limits to time, and in a state of thermal equilibrium, then probabilistically, we are more likely to be disembodied brains that fluctuated into existence. We would be Boltzmann brains that think we are living in our well-ordered universe rather than the product of a real such universe.